Supporters of Don Nichols for U.S. Senate are ecstatic at this hour as they predict victory for their candidate. I'm Bella Shaw, and I'll have that story.
Bella?
Thank you very much, Linda. It is an exciting evening here at Nichols headquarters, naturally, because they are ahead at this point. They've been watching Ronald Reagan's landslide victory, and they are pretty sure that means victory for them, too. Now, Nichols is not here yet. We expect him momentarily, but with me is the Reverend Jim Vineyard. He is the head of the Moral Majority in Oklahoma County, and the Moral Majority has been attributed to playing a big role in the campaign. I understand you've been starving yourself since Sunday and holding prayer vigils. Could you explain?
And I believe Don Nichols would have won anyway.
Well, thank you very much. As I said earlier, Don Nichols is not here yet. Now, he should be coming within the next 5 or 10 minutes, so we'll get back to this headquarters in just a minute. First, let's switch over to Susie Webb at Andy Coates' headquarters. Susie?
For your efforts and for your hard work, for your phone calls and knocking on the doors, Linda and I and our whole family, we appreciate it and we love you very, very much. Thank you.
Admit, Reagan's landslide victory throughout the country must have had some effect. You're on the coattails there and the heels
Certainly.
Of his campaign.
Right. Well, I think Ronald Reagan was, of course, a very, very big asset to
Kennedy. Kennedy was 30 years old when he was elected. Russell Long was 30 years old when he was elected.
You will be the youngest from Oklahoma ever elected.
Well, that's fantastic. Glad to hear that.
Don, you won Oklahoma.
Okay, now we'll go back to Election Central. Thank you, Don.
Thank you.